Hi. So today I'll be teaching about 5FFIC timing circuit. But before I start with that, I would like to have you look at your electronics notes, and that is on page 1. You will see this diagram here explaining this thing called potential difference. So potential difference, okay, basically means voltage, and it actually describes how actually charging flows from one end of the battery to the other end of the battery. So we all know that for current to flow, there needs to be electrical energy, and what carries this electrical energy is actually the flow of electric charges or the flow of electrons. So for the electrons to flow, for the electric charges to flow, there needs to be potential difference. Okay, so this concept you must understand. Okay, now we're going to the page 19. So page 19 is a little concept map that explains the different type of timing circuit. So basically there are two types: resistor capacitor circuit or RC circuit, and the other one is 5FFIC. Okay, so IC stands for integrated circuit, and then both resistor capacitor circuit, RC circuit, and 5FFIC integrated circuit, they allow one to create delay on and delay off function. Also, something special about 5FFIC is that it's able to create pulsating output. That means the output can on and off, so it is like a pulse like that. Right, so now let's go into the loops of it. So on page 22, okay, we have 5FFIC description here. And the first part says integrated circuit are made of very tiny circuits etched onto the chips of silicon. So what this means is that, you know, it's so tiny that it can be placed in the palm of the hands. Okay, so as such, right, a lot of technology is going into making very very small little chips that comprises of many electronic components. And it becomes very compact, and it allows our electronic devices to be very, very small these days. So as you scroll down the page, okay, you will see the 5FFIC has many circuits in this diagram here. Has many components. It is integrated with many, many circuits. Okay, and for 5FFIC, you need to know that there are 8 pins. So all these that you see, these are the pins. Okay, so they are all together 8 pins. Right, so every integrated chip has this notch here, this U shape here. Okay, and this will indicate where should pin number 1 be, because on the left of this notch, it's pin number 1. And then it goes down all the way to the top. So it's a U-turn, right? It goes down like that, and goes down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now I always like to joke that 5FFIC, the word 5FFIC in Thai means ha ha ha. Ha ha means laugh, when ha 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 means you're laughing, right? So this is like a smiling face now. So if you look at this smiling face and you look to the left in this smiling face, okay, then you start from 1 and go all the way to 8. So it's the ha 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 IC. So you know that there is a smiling face, you look at another smiling face and you go. You go to the left, and then from there, pin number 1 starts, and then you go down, make a U-turn, and then go up. Okay, the next thing is you need to know a magic number. I'm going to tell you this magic number. Okay, and this magic number is 2376. 2376, or 2367, okay, they are the same. So you don't need to know all the pins, but these four pins are the main pin that you can know. So pin 2 is the trigger, so when current goes into pin 2, okay, the 555 IC will be triggered on, and then immediately there will be output coming out to pin number 3. Okay, then pin number 7 and pin number 6. Pin number 7 will receive a discharge current from the capacitor, which you will see in the circuit later. And pin number 6 is the threshold. Okay, a threshold to trigger, okay, when there is a voltage drop. Okay, so now if you recall, right, your RC timing circuit, okay, the output gradually turn off or gradually turn on. There is this gradual part here. So RC circuit not so good, huh? Because it's not very accurate. Okay, it's not precise. Whereas you look at 555 IC circuit, the moment it is triggered, okay, then you can see it's off in it. Okay, it's off in it. Often, okay. Oh, so there is an instantaneous reaction. It is very precise and it's also very small, and thus it makes it very useful in timing circuits. Okay, so there are two kinds of timing circuit: monostable and stable. Monostable means, you know, you just switch on something for a certain amount of time, or you just switch off something for a certain amount of time. Stable basically means it's a pulse generator. It will just turn on and off, on and off, on and off, like a pulse after. So the first monostable circuit that we can talk about is the delay off. How do we create the delay off? Okay, now the best way to look at a 555 IC, like I said, is to identify all the pins, pin number 1 all the way to pin number 8. Okay. So in the exam, they may not give you the pin number, so you have to look at the smiling face. Okay, then the next thing is to look at pin 2, 3, 7, 6. So you highlight this. Okay, then remember, cover always has to go into pin 2, then 555 IC. So if you go, well, you trace back, cover will fall from positive end of the battery, right? It will not go into any of the pins because the 555 IC is not triggered. So the first place where cover will flow is to flow into pin 2. So if you backtrack pin 2, okay, cover will go straight into pin 2 first. The moment S1 is being pressed. Okay? So S1 is like the trigger button, and then cover can go to pin 2, then 555 is turned on. And then when 555 is turned on, this LED will turn on. So if you look at the voltage time graph for the output, which is the LED, the moment it is triggered on, it will remain on for some time. Okay? Now, remember I said when pin 2 is being triggered on, current come up from pin 3, right? And then at the same time, all the other pins also will be turned on. So when all the other pins turn on, current now can go to pin 7 and 6, as well as it can go to this capacitor. Now when this capacitor receives current, it charges. Okay, it charges. Then when it's fully charged, it will discharge. Okay, so when does the current discharge? It will discharge back to pin 7 and pin 6. Okay, we'll just detect the voltage drop. Okay, charges will flow into pin 7 and pin 6 will just detect the voltage drop. So pin 6, in a way, is like is a plastic bag collecting all the charges. While pin 7 is the one that activates the 555 to turn on. Okay, so when charges go into pin 7, 555 IC turns off. So the moment 555 IC turns off, output turns off. Okay, 555 IC turn. So when the capacitor is fully charged, it discharges, right? 555 IC turn on. So this period here is the time delay, and this time delay is controlled by the capacitor. Okay, by the capacitor. Because the capacitor needs time to charge. right? And the moment when it's fully charged, then it can discharge, right? And then the discharge from the capacitor goes into pin 7, then 555 is charged. So the capacitance value of the capacitor will affect them. The next component is the resistor R1. This resistor R1 will also affect the voltage drop that goes in. So this resistor value here will also affect the time delay. Okay, because this one will affect the voltage drop. So this will affect, okay, the amount of voltage drop detected, and at the same time that will also affect the amount of current, the amount of time it takes to charge. Okay, the amount of time it takes to charge. So basically, in short, right, the moment when the value of C1 and R1 increase, time delay will increase. Then when you make the value smaller, okay, time delay will be shorter. Okay, so in short, this is how a 555 delay off circuit works. Okay, so you may want to replay this part of the video so that you understand how the 555 IC works. Okay, so we can do this replay. Okay, the next one is the 555 delay on circuit. Okay, this is the 555 delay on. That means at the start it doesn't turn on, output doesn't turn on. Okay, at the start output doesn't turn on. It is only when after the capacitor is fully charged and then discharged in the pin 7, then the 555 IC is off. Okay, output then turns on. So the on comes later. Okay, so now if you look at this circuit, same thing like carbon flow for another battery, but it has to go into pin 2 first, right? 2, 3, 7, 6. So it has to go to pin 2 first. So likewise, when you press this, carbon go into pin 2. Okay, then when carbon go into pin 2, then 555 IC will turn on. But you notice here, okay, when this turns on, although carbon can come on pin number 3, but the voltage of the carbon is 9 volt. And then if you look at this LED, right? This LED is connected to 9 volt. So this is 9 volt and this is 9 volt. There is no potential difference. So remember what I said earlier, there must be potential difference and current can flow. So there's no potential difference, so current can flow. So at the start, although output 3 is on, current cannot flow. So that's why you look at the graph, right, of the LED. Okay, the voltage is at 0 volt at the start. Okay, and how long will it remain off? It depends on how long it takes for this capacitor C1 charge. So when current goes into C1, right, it will charge C1, and then when it's fully charged, then it is charged. So how long it remains off depends on how long it C1 is being charged. So only when it's fully charged, current is charged at pin 7, then for IC turns off. Okay, so when 5 IC turns off, then what happens is this will no longer be 0 volt. And now there is a potential difference, so this thing will turn on. So when the C1 is fully charged and we discharge to pin 7, then the 5 IC turns off, so there will be a 0 volt at output. This is where the LED turns on. Okay, this is where the LED turns on. Okay, so please read through this and then replay the video so that you understand. Okay, all right, now I'm going to a stable circuit. A stable means pulse generating or pulse generator. So the missed output is a pulse. Okay. Now, notice here, this is just a rocker switch. Okay, there's no pulse switch. And pin 7 and 6 are not connected to each other. Now, for monostable, okay, pin 7 and 6 are connected to each other. There's no resistor between them. Now, just look at pin number, look at a stable circuit. Okay, there is a resistor separating pin 7 and 6. Okay, so pin 7 and 6 are not connected to each other. So this is a stable. Okay. So how does it work? Okay, same thing, like you press this, carbon will flow into pin 2. Then this thing turns on. Alright, so then output turns on. LED turns on. At the same time, carbon will go into C1 and charge it. So it will take some time to charge. Then when it's fully charged, it will discharge to pin 7. Right? And pin 6 will detect the voltage drop. So when it, you know, when it discharge to pin 7, 555 IC turns on. Then 555 IC turns on. What will happen is this thing turns on. Okay? So now when this thing turns on, power still can flow in, you know, the pin 2, because this switch will remain pressed. So power still can flow in the pin 2, and then this thing will trigger this on again, and then pin 3 will output again. And then when it outputs, then LED turns on. Likewise, then cover will go and charge this capacitor and it takes time to charge. Then when it's fully charged, discharge the pin 7, IC turns off, output turns on. And then cover will continue to go to pin 2 to turn it on again. So the sun will on. Then after that, cover will charge this, wait for this to be fully charged and discharge the pin 7. Okay, turns off this, then turns off the LED. Okay, so this is how it works on. Okay, so please replay this part of the video, okay, a few times until you understand, and then also read the description so you understand the status. Okay, so that's all for PCB. So in summary, let's go back to page 19. I have shared with you there are two types of ICs. Circuit, monostable circuit and stable circuit. Monostable, we got a circuit that teaches you, okay, how to make sure the output, right, will turn on only for a certain time, so the off comes later, okay, delay on. Then I'll share with you there's also another way, okay, to make the output only turn on after a certain period of time. So the on is being delayed, so that's called the delay on monostable circuit. Then I have also mentioned to you, right, the stable circuit, that is a pulse generating circuit. Okay, how to create that. Then also, I have mentioned the benefits of using 555 IC over RC circuit. And one of the benefits is 555 IC is more precise and accurate. And the other one is the circuits are all compact in one chip, so the size of the whole circuit tree is very small. Okay? Right, so that's all for today's lesson. Thank you.